Hello guys, how are you? And welcome back to The Manager's Journey with me, John, aka Old Man Suda. And we've got a big thing to talk about today. Some big news happened. If you've seen on my Twitter, you'll know what I'm talking about. But we'll get through it to it in a minute. Before I do that, first things first, if you're new to this series and you're enjoying it, please do hit that sub button and the like button. You know, comment as well if you want to. You know, your support means the world to me. So thank you for watching, even if you don't hit that button. But if you do feel like it, please do. And for all you guys who have already here and are back again, thank you for your continued support. We'll get through to what we've done so far in the league and all that sort of stuff, and then we'll talk about the news. So the last episode was 1-0 against Fife. After that, we played Sutton. We beat them 3-1. Really comfortable win for us, as you can see there. Armisen Walters and Brisket both all getting the goals for us. They did come back sort of like in the second half a little bit, but we had managed to hold off really well, and it was a good comfortable win for us in the end. We then beat Spennymoor 1-0 in the FA Cup. Good result for us overall, because we need the cash, which is more than anything else. Puts us probably through to the first round. Good chance to get through to the second round, because as you can see, we've got Dorking Wanderers, who are in a league, they're in a league below us, and they're near the bottom of that league. So really, you'd think this is going to be a game we should be able to win and get through to the next round. So yeah, a really good important win for us there. After that, we dipped a little bit. We placed Eastleigh, and to be honest, we did lucky to hold on to a 0-0. We just didn't turn up to this game at all. They were the better side, but they couldn't score, we couldn't score. It was a boring game. We then lost to Chesterfield 3-0. This was one of those games, doesn't matter what little tweaks I did or anything like that during the game, Chesterfield were just too strong for us. Maybe it was a little bit, again, we just weren't quite in the game at all, and we just didn't get there at all. And yeah, it was a really, really bad game for us. Lost 3-0. Not much else to say apart from that. We then played Gateshead. Good win, 6-1. Gateshead near the bottom of the league, but a really good bounce back after the 3-0 loss. As you can see there, Jeff has got a hat-trick for us. Armisen James got a goal. They scored an own goal as well in the third minute. Yeah, just a really, really good. We were 5-0 at half-time. I thought it was going to be like a 7 or 8-0 game, but we, you know, these games, you score 4 or 5. I hit my pen, my smoking pen over. Yeah, one of those games where after the first half we played fantastic, second half we dropped off a little bit, but we'd won the game by that point anyway. So really good result for us overall, and it means we are third in the league, which is more than we could ask for really. After just being promoted, I was expecting us to be at least mid-table, but it's very, very close up here. A couple of points either way, and you could find yourself mid-table. So a couple of wins, a couple of losses, and anything could happen. Barnet, who we've got today, top of the league. They're 5 points clear now. They look like the strong side of the league at the moment. But I think overall we're doing absolutely fantastic, and if we can carry on the form, even if we finish it in the sort of top 10, I'd be happy. But you know, if we can finish in the playoffs or something like that, it'd be absolutely fantastic. If we stay with Brackley till the end of the season, that is, because this is what happened. Exeter City offered us a job interview. I put it out on Twitter to say should I attend to the interview. The Twitter have sort of said that we should, so thank you to everyone who had voted. It really does mean the world to me. I have my reservations about Exeter City. I had a little look at them myself. They've got quite a big squad, which means that their wage budget is probably not a lot left, if anything. They've got some players who are on quite high wages, even for this league. I mean, you know, 2,600, 1,800. There's some big wages there, really. There's some reservations I have. They do have a decent size stadium and everything like that. They've got a good estimated value, good sort of facilities and that. So there is parts of it. They've got a capacity of 8,500. There's parts that look really, really appealing. There's other parts that just look a little bit, yeah, I'm not 100% sure. And we're going to take the interview and talk to them, but I'm not sure if we will take the job yet. It's something I've got a little think about. There's a couple other things that really do sort of make me a bit as well. If I go to the job security and you have a look at some of the teams that are maybe either insecure, all that sort of stuff. You've got Accrington, who are insecure there. I don't think that we're going to get the championships ones. I don't think they're too high for us, I feel. But you've also got the likes of Northampton. You've got Peterborough, who I think we could possibly get. You've got Lincoln, Newport are there. There's some teams that really do sort of maybe whet my appetite a little bit more. I mean, the rest of them are sort of secure, but there's definitely a couple of teams there that do sort of whet my appetite. And you don't know, as managers move to certain other jobs, which other jobs could possibly come available. So I have my reservations about Exeter. We will do the interview and see what they say. But like I said, I do have my reservations, and it may be that I just don't feel like we could or we will move that. I don't know if it's the right move. But let's get through anyway. You have very little managing experience, and this obviously concerns me a little. Can you explain this? I think, what can we say? I may not have the experience you're looking for, but I've done very well in my limited time in club management. I think that's an honest opinion. You've done some highly impressive work. Why do you want to move? I feel like I've taken them as far as I can. No, it's not that. I believe I'm in a position to take the positive momentum I've built recently and use it to hit ground running here. I've been seeking a new challenge for a while. I think it's just I want to take the next step. I will just say that. It would be quite a challenge for you if you were to leave your current job to come here. Are you confident? Of course I'm confident. I have think that my body of work, I'm ambitious. I want to work at the very highest level, and I want to be given opportunities such as this one. We'll just say that. With your team currently defining expectations, I've done a good job here and feel this is the right time to take the next step in my career. That's the honest truth. You have been breaking promises to your players before. Is there anything you have to say about this? It happened a long time ago. It was last season. We want to ensure that the dressing room, I think we could have a strong dressing room. Print didn't enjoy relationships with the supporters. I have a good relationship with the supporters. We'll say that. No, we don't want to make any budget changes. We will say sign players, a large amount of youth players there, because it's green there. So we'll say that, because obviously it's something they would like to see. So we'll say that and nothing else. If hired, we expect you to secure survival and avoid relegation. Is that fair? If you're not, I think I could meet those and avoid relegation. What do you think of the proposed transfer budget of £334k? Yeah, that's absolutely fine. And the wage budget will say absolutely fine as well. I have no requests to say. And we'll see what happens. I'm a little bit, like I said, dubious about it. We'll see what happens. It could work out well. I mean, this is where I need your guys to help me, though. Let me know what you guys think as well. Do you think we should hold out and see if we can get something maybe a little bit more? More in line to what we'd maybe want? Or do you think we should take the extra job? Let me know, because obviously you guys are important on this as well. I want to take the moment just to praise you for your training. We'll criticise you for your training. I'm just, as I'm talking to you, clicking the buttons and going through the motions. Exeter have approached us. Right. Exeter have approached us. What do we do now? I wasn't expecting this. I was expecting it to like at least have a game or so before, in between them doing this. I mean, the wage budget would be good. Let's have a look at Exeter and see. Like I said, they've got some high wages, which concern me. You know, that's definitely a concern. Let's go to the overview. Their captain is Dean Moxie. Vice-captain Aaron Martin. Key player is Ryan Bowman, who is a striker. Looks reasonably good. Nothing fantastic. 27-year-old. What's his history like? 44 games, 12 goals. He scored 11 games. He's had 5 goals. He used to play at Motherwell. Played at Gateshead. He's not anything amazingly, is he? One hot prospect in getting Kalonji. I'm terrible with names, ain't I? Striker, decent finish. He looks like he could turn out to be a really good player, actually, overall. Good training, 2-star training, youth reputations 2-star, finances 3-star. I don't know. I mean, they've been a sort of League 2. They went up to League 1 at one point, but they've been a League 2 side for quite the last few seasons overall. What's the staff look like? Not bad overall, not bad senior squad staff. They've got a fitness coach, goalkeeper coach. Got some decent coaches, it looks like. Tactics for the senior squad. They're playing a 4-4-2. I don't know if that is a 4-4-2 they're playing, or if it's just what they're been sort of showing. What's their results been like? They've had 2 draws lately, a couple of losses, draws. I mean, I don't know. They drew 2 against Northampton. God. This is a really, really difficult choice to make. I feel like I should end the episode and get you guys to make the choice for me overall, but there's something just pulling me away from this job. I'm not quite sure what it is. There is something just not feeling right. What's their transfer history like? Made a lot of free transfers this season, and loaned out 2 players overall. Do you know what? This job doesn't feel right. There's something about this job that just doesn't feel right for the move for us. I'm going to walk away. I don't feel like it's the right move for us. I feel like there's in the next, you know, we're getting into that period where Platt manages to get sacked around Christmas time and that. We're in the beginning of November. I honestly think that there is an opportunity. We're not going to Brackley Town now for a second. We're not going to take this, for the basic fact is that I've always said this was going to be my last season. So we'll decline the talks here. If we change our mind, we can always ask them for a contract. But there's something about the Exeter job that just didn't feel right. I'm not sure what it was, but there is something about that job that just doesn't feel quite right. And I feel like there are some jobs up here coming up, or possibly coming up, I should say, not coming up, but possibly coming up. Like I said, like the Northampton job or the Peterborough job, even somewhere like maybe the Lincoln job. I mean, you've got Hibernian there. We could possibly look at somewhere like that. I know it's a bit of a move, but possibly could happen. You never know. Accrington are there as well. I mean, I think the Derby and Swansea job might be a bit too much for us. But, yeah, there was just something about it. Something just didn't feel right. Let's get through. We'll do the Barnet game anyway. And then we'll see what happens in the next episode. But this is going to be the team. It's going to be Dorber. It's going to be Owen Edwards, Coveney. No, it's not going to be Coveney. It's going to be Dean. Dean and Patterson. We're going to have Brian and Walker. We'll swap you two around, actually. You play better that way around. Walters, Armisen, Carey and Jeffers. A couple of players have swapped out, of like Sterling James, just because he's a little bit tired. No, we'll keep him out, actually. I just feel there's the possibility. He's a bit tired. We need to rest him. This is an important game. We need to have fit players for it. It should hopefully work out okay. We'll see how we get on anyway. I think it could work out okay for us. We might drop Armisen back and just create a free in the midfield if things don't look like they're working out too well for us. But overall, I think we'll stick with how we're doing. Let's give the fans a good performance. It didn't do a bloody thing. And let's get into the game and see how we get on. Luckily, we've got FA Cup game next, so we can actually rest one or two players maybe for that as well. But this is a game. And Barnet is going to be a really tough game. This is a game I'm not expecting us to run away with. I'll be happy with a draw. If we can still win, that'd be great. But Barnet are a good side, and it's going to be a bloody difficult one. But we've got maybe a chance here. Owen puts it into Jeffers. Jeffers can't quite get in there. Barnet now got the ball, takes a shot, and it's just wide. And we've started off really, really strong. As you can see, there are 3 shots, none on target, though. Barnet have had 1 on target. I mean, we're looking like we are the better side at the moment, but there's a long way to go in this game, and Barnet are a really good side, so we've got to be quite careful. 16 minutes gone now, and we've got a chance possibly here. Walters with the ball, gives it back to Patterson. Patterson can get it into inside to Armisen. Armisen to Walters. Walters gets it to Walker. Walker does finally get there to Armisen, to Jeffers. Jeffers with a shot, and I'm not sure what happened there, because it looked like it was going really slow, hit the keeper and like shot off like a rocket. It's a goal. We'll see it in 3D, see what it looked like. But Walters gets the ball here to Walker. Walker does get it and gets a nice little pass to Armisen, who knocks it to Jeffers. Jeffers takes a shot, and it was like it span off the goalkeeper's hand. And you remember like in Sonic, where you had the little platforms that would like make you spin really fast? It was almost like that. 24 minutes gone, and we're 1-0 up. We'll take it. It's a goal. We'll take it. It's an absolute brilliant opportunity for us as well. We're going to put that onto league table. Hey, when it changes every time you have an FA Cup game or something like that. Puts us actually up into second in the league if things carry on like this. 42 minutes gone, and we're going to go into half time 1-0 up after a bizarre goal, but we'll take it. It's a goal. And things are looking really good for us at the moment. Alright, what can we say apart from passionately, I'm pleased with how things are. Keep it up. We're winning. We'll carry on. As we start the second half, and this could be an interesting second half at the moment. It's been a really close even game, as you can see. We've had a bit more possession. We'll mark you down a little bit more, but we might have a chance to get two goals here. Armson on Kerry now. Can he do anything with it? He can't. Couldn't quite keep it in. Owen with the ball, gives it to Walker. We might have a chance here. Kerry to Armson. Armson to Byrne. Byrne's got a bit of room. Oh, good shot. Get in there. Shane Bryan with the goal. 2-0. This is what we're talking about. I mean, every win like this helps us with looking for jobs as well. Kerry gives it to Armson. Armson with a nice hit. I mean, number 19 should have gone with him maybe and stopped him. But a good goal. Put it just wide of the keeper, really. And we go 2-0 up with 60 minutes gone. This is absolutely fantastic. In a game that is looking like it's either like end-to-end stuff. Not maybe seeing the highlights, but it's looking that way. We'll make some substitutions. Walker's looking a bit tired, so we're going to bring on Williams for him. Williams plays a bit better central midfielder. He should be a defensive midfielder. Walters is not playing great for us. We haven't got anyone who can go out there, though. We could put Kerry out there and bring Walker on, Glenn Walker that is, for him. Apart from that, let's leave it and see how we get on. 20 minutes to go, we are 2-0 up, things are looking brilliant. Somehow we've dropped back down to third. Aldershot are winning, it looks like. The time's ticking away and nothing really happening now. We're going winning this game. This is going to be an absolutely magical result for us. Dorber kicks the ball out. There's 3 minutes still to go, so this probably isn't the end of game highlight. Edward give it back to Dorber, who puts it forward. Jeff has just stood still, though, as now Barnett can come forward. And don't tell me they're going to score with a minute or so to go. As Mendy with the ball to Chapman, Mason Clark, whoever Johnson. Frost gets the goal. It's been disallowed. It was offside. Phew! Thank God for that. I mean, how much offside was he? Oh, that was close. That was close. He was just offside. Not by much. Just offside. 2-0, though. And hopefully that is going to go. Can we make one more substitution? Shane Bryan's looking absolutely shattered. Coveney, you can just go there for now. Just to see out the last 30 seconds or so, as there's one maybe more opportunity, or this could be the end of the game highlight, I'm not quite sure, as they bring the ball forward. Dean clears it though, and Armson with the ball now gives it to Brian, the goal scorer, back to Armson. Surely this is just wasting time now. There's 10 seconds left. Surely there can't be a goal or anything like that. Owen gets the ball nicely, he tries to get up to Jeffers, he gives it to Armson, and there you go, we do win it 2-0. Get in there, my son. That is what we wanted. A really close game, a really tough game. I didn't expect us to win it. Passionately, that was really special. That's all we can say. That was really special because that is absolutely a brilliant result for us overall. Right. I think we probably will be ending the episode here because obviously we did have that bit of talking about Exeter City. We'll praise you quickly, shall we, as well. But the episode's gone on quite a bit now. So we'll go back to the normal two-game format, obviously, next episode, unless we get offered more jobs. There isn't any more jobs, just quickly check it. Ooh, there's a lot more jobs. There is the Peterborough job, and we are, ooh, the Peterborough job, and we're favourites for it. Right, guys, I really need, if you watch this episode, please let me know, should we go for the Peterborough job? In fact, what I will do is, I will apply for it because that's a big job. Peterborough could be huge. Peterborough could be a huge job to go to. But let me know what you guys think. Have a little look and see. There's the Peterborough job. There's the Northampton job. Accrington are there as well. That's some big jobs. That's some big ones. The Peterborough one would be a huge step up for us and could be something massive. And we are favourites for it. So yeah, let me know what you guys think. Anyway, if we come back for a Brackley game and we haven't got a job with Peterborough, it's going to be probably the Wrexham game we'll probably come back for. But we might be coming back for a game as manager of Peterborough. Who knows? I'll see you on the next episode. Thank you for watching. It's been a pleasure as always. Remember to like and subscribe. Bye for now.